Greetings, I'm Caffeine Rage, and I'm back with more Mafia 2. Last time, things are coming unraveled, big time. As Joe gets picked up by Vinci's guys, and, well, we at least got our half of the debt we paid, so there's that. And now, as we get run over, we're going off to the bar to try to rescue Joe.
Freeze, and maybe I won't kill you.
Hi, fellas.
Look at the balls on this guy.
Nice to see you, too.
Don't move a muscle. Come on. Listen to the friendly bartender and stop fucking around, Vito. Now, first of all, I gotta ask you to slowly toss your guns on the floor. No funny business, neither. The bartender's got the itchiest trigger finger in town, huh?
I'm not armed.
Okay, so what are you doing here, Vito? We wasn't expecting you.
I'm looking for Joe Barbaro. I heard some of your guys picked him up.
Eh, yeah, maybe.
What are you trying to pull? Me and Joe didn't do nothing to you.
Mr. Vinci doesn't seem to think so. He wanted a few things explained to him. So that's what Joe is doing. And since you've stopped by, why don't we go and join them?
And what if I don't want to?
These guns say you do. But don't worry. It's got a hell of a view.
Shit. Ah. Hey, what's up, Joe?
The assholes went to take a leak.
Great. But can you explain to me why the fuck we're here?
That old fuck Vinci can't see what's going on right in front of his face. And he thinks I can explain it to him. Idiot.
Oh, the happy couple is here already. Welcome, Vito.
What's going on? You got no reason to treat us like this.
No reason? No reason? First, the business with Leo. And then all hell breaks out in the city. The chinks, they're going nuts. Everybody's fighting like lunatics. And now, those yellow bastards are threatening to kill me. It's out of fucking control.
Now, I'm too old for this shit, so you're gonna tell me what the hell's going on here. Come on, I'm all ears.
Mr. Vinci, look. I don't know what the hell's going on here. Believe me, me and Joe ain't got nothing to do with it.
That ain't what I wanna hear.
Yeah, well, that's your problem. Because we don't know shit about any of this.
That's too bad.
Finally. We don't got much time. We gotta do something.
All right. We'll try to break the pipe. Come on, help me out. I can't do it by myself.
Okay.
One, two, three! One, two, three! Again! One, two, three!
Fuck you! You filthy fuck! Come on! Come on, you fuck!
Ah, gun again. Oh, no, wrong side. Damn cover, you idiot. Let's see if we can get a stealth kill going. Nice and quiet. And that was my problem before, was that I had a gun in my hand, so I couldn't just pistol whip him. Of course, I am losing these guns, but I think it's probably for the best. Or maybe I could just only do stealth kills when they're above cover. Or, sorry, not above cover, but just right at a ledge.
The fuck was that noise?
Ah, shit, they're loose! Ah. Oh.
Hmm. Well, that wasn't clean, but hey, it worked. And now the question is how to get the hell out of here. Do we go up? Oh, no, down. Oh. Whoa. And we're going to have to redo that, aren't we?
Fuck you. You yep. Filthy fuck.
Come of course on. We are. Come on, you
fuck.
Because it would have been far too convenient just to have to do this and be done with it. That's him down. Go ahead and take care of this guy. Sneak up behind him.
The fuck was that noise?
Shit, that loop!
And that guy just cannot hear worth a damn. What was hearing aids like back in the 50s? So I have a feeling he needs one. Really? All right, that's those guys down. Good thing they didn't rub me up too much that I can't fight. Oh, good. Joe has a weapon now. Should be a guy right here somewhere. There he is.
Asswipe?
Really? That's your wise guy catchphrase before you die? Reminds me of a kid I knew. A kid I knew growing up. His big thing was calling people butt wipes. It was my friend's little brother. He was one of those annoying little kid brothers. But then again, is there a kid brother that isn't annoying in some regard? Come on. That's him down. Should be two over to the right, which there are. Ah, there's one over to the right. Now there's none over to the right.
You go first. I'll cover you.
Thanks, Joe.
There's a. Where the fuck is that your boat? Hey, guys!
Hey, guys! Ugh, was the last thing he ever said. I wonder if he knew that one was coming up when he got out of bed today. Fall back, regen some health. The gunfights just feel so slow-paced, don't they? Just because I have to fall back for health so often. Maybe it's just my lack of skill, I don't know. Oh, where the?
How you like that, huh? Come on!
I hear him, but I don't see him. I hear fire. Wait, how did he aggro me while I was still... Whoa. And we're gonna have to do this entire stuff. Thank you, checkpoint system. You actually didn't suck this time.
Where the fuck you think you're going?
Okay, that was... That's the last one on these stairs, I believe. Now we just have to.
How you like that, huh?
Ugh. I didn't have a shot on him at all. This is going to be frustrating, isn't it? I just gotta be careful of that one shotgun guy, don't I? Because, boy, he could just knock the hell out. A shotgun could just knock the hell out of you, huh? Which is kind of realistic when you think about it, but at the same time, it's frustrating game design. I could be at when I'm at about 2/3 health. Yeah, Joe, get in there.
Vito, come here. This should be the way out. Get your ass over here, Vito.
I'm letting Joe take some fire here because, well, I really don't want to have to start over again. Shit. Joe picked up a shotgun. Did he pick up that one guy's shotgun?
I gotta do everything myself.
And these crates are tough, whatever they're filled with. That's another guy down. Come on. Another one down. Just nice and slow. Even though slow is not exactly exciting. Oh shit. I was just trying to get a better gun before Joe grabbed it. Oh shit. Oh, there's one guy left in there. Phew. That's that guy down. We'll take that. Ooh, I'll definitely take that. Swap out to the Thompson. Not many bullets for it, but there's a shotgun. Grenades! We haven't actually used grenades in ages. Just making sure that they're not being a dick on me again, and save point. So that's doesn't seem like I could throw grenades while in cover, which is lovely. Come on. Pull the proper gun. There we go. Sorry I'm not talking all that much, but you've seen how things have been going lately in these major gunfights for me, so I'm just trying to pay attention. Let's see what I have that has a lot of ammo. Yeah, should probably reload the shotgun nonetheless. Actually, we've ran through a lot of the gangsters out here. Oh shit. What the hell are you stuck on? Joe, you coming? Come on. Looks like there should be two more out here somewhere. There they are. Not graceful shots, but I'll take them. Phew.
Get your ass over here, Vito.
Oh, shut up, Joe. I'm grabbing ammo because I have a feeling we're gonna need it. I think that's actually a replacement for the grease gun. No, it's... There we go. Got our Tommy gun all situated.
Vito, they fucked me up pretty good. I think I need a doctor.
Okay, let's get you over to El Greco.
Now let's just see if we can get a car before, without drawing too much attention to ourselves. Joe, I realize you need a doctor, but you don't need one that bad.
Get the fuck out.
Ah, great.
Come on, have a heart.
Phew. Okay, it seems like it. They only care if I'm actually actively taking the car at the moment. Which is also good to know.
So tell us, Ace, what's your secret? Just what do you put into that car?
My chest. Every time I breathe. I think they broke my damn ribs.
Take it easy. El Greco's gonna fix you up.
Yeah. Sure. fuck. Every time I cough, it feels like I'm being stabbed in the chest.
Just sit back. The more you whine about it, the worse it's gonna be.
So listen, Vito. Thanks for coming after me. That almost getting yourself killed.
Hey, we're in this together, right? Just like always. Now just sit the fuck back before you get blood all over my pants and I really do stab you in the chest.
Oh, you picked a hell of a time to turn into a fucking comedian.
So, unless there's some more dialogue, I'm going to go ahead and skip ahead to El Greco's. Because there's really no reason to have this long drive. And we're already threatening to run a little bit long. Okay, here we are at El Greco's. So, there should be a little bit of a cutscene here, I'd imagine. As I knock down his gates.
Your hand?
I can make it.
What do you want me to do with the money?
Take it to Bruno.
All right. At least that'll be out of the way.
Good evening, gentlemen. Oh, what happened to you?
Hey, Doc. I got my ass kicked and I'm coughing up
what
blood.
What is happening today? One of your guys is already here.
Who?
His name is Antonio Balsamo.
Tony Balls? What happened to him?
Somebody messed him up pretty good. I don't think he's ever going to walk again.
What?
This surprises you? All the blood, all the death. This is the lifestyle you choose. One day your luck is bound to run out. The next time, it could be you.
And off with the sermon, Doc. You have time to treat Joe?
Yes, but you'll have to wait a minute while I fix Antonio up.
That's okay, Doc.
All right, come in.
Make sure you settle things with Bruno, okay? And Vito, thanks.
Sure thing. Feel better.
And that's going to be it for today. Next time we'll pay Bruno back and who knows, maybe get screwed over again. I don't know. Until then, thank you for watching and I'll see you then.